More than 1 million Sydneysiders and visitors from around Australia and across the globe descended on the harbour foreshore to ring in the new year, in a celebration hailed as an overwhelming success by police praising the crowd's behaviour. About 1.6 million people attended the fireworks, where a rainbow waterfall off the Sydney Harbour Bridge celebrated the legalising of same-sex marriage. 7 people were arrested for assaulting police, and another 6 arrests were made for a variety of offences, including offensive behaviour and affray. Assistant Commissioner Mark Walton says the only downside was the use of illegal fireworks. One concern that remains is that right across Sydney we've had a number of unauthorised fireworks that have been let off. And unfortunately again this year we've had someone injured, he said. But Assistant Commissioner Mark Walton, a veteran of 15 New Year's Eve operations, said there had been a cultural shift. We aren't seeing the amount of alcohol consumption and antisocial behaviour that we used 2 years ago, he said. Police also commended the behaviour of crowds in South Australia, where 2 people were arrested in Glebe and Adelaide CBD, and in Brisbane and Perth, where police said there were no major incidents. St John Ambulance's Joel Moore said partygoers had stayed safe in Perth. We had a spike in workload in the city and the Armidale area, and overall there is a lot of people in those areas, and overall the crowds have been quite well behaved. Police provided a strong presence in Fremantle, the CBD and at the Origin Music Festival. In Canberra, thousands of people crowded into Civic from the early evening and cleaners this morning prepared to clear away up to 3,000 kilograms of rubbish mostly from bins set out for the night's celebrations. Police made 238 arrests in Victoria, up 55 on the previous New Year. They arrested 99 people for drunkenness, 23 for assault and 22 for drug offences. Meanwhile, not all fireworks displays went off without a hitch. A 17-year-old boy on Sydney's northern beaches was taken to hospital after he suffered serious burns when unauthorised fireworks went off in Cromer Heights just before midnight, and a man suffered serious hand injuries when a firework he was holding exploded in Melbourne's west. Police said the 34-year-old was injured in the accident at around 10:30 p.m. in Caroline Springs. He was taken to hospital in a serious condition and police are continuing investigations into the incident. A 42-year-old man from Brunswick West also injured his hand while lighting an illegal firework, and a third man, in his 30s, suffered burns after a firework exploded in his face at Melton shortly before 12:30 a.m. He was flown to hospital with non-life-threatening injuries. Crowds who had flocked to see the New Year's Eve fireworks at Terrigal on the New South Wales Central Coast got more than they bargained for when the display malfunctioned, causing the fireworks to go off all at once. Hundreds of people gathered on the beach had to be evacuated, and the 2 men operating the fireworks display from a barge had to jump into the water to escape the explosions. They were taken to hospital with minor injuries.